Hello and welcome to part 4 of my little panoramic photography tutorial series. My name's Florian and I run the website pano.ie, which you're very welcome to visit. Anyway, today I will show you how to stitch the images from the third technique that I showed you in the first video of the series, which was done with a 8mm fisheye lens on a crop camera from a tripod. What I will show you in this tutorial is how to stitch the images together, taking care of the tripod. So let's open these images in PTGui Pro. There we go. The first thing again, because it's an 8mm fisheye lens, we have the image circle that we need to take care of. So we go to the crop tab and adjust the circle like so, just to tell PTGui which part of the image is the actual image and which part is just the inside of the barrel of the fisheye lens. Now, once this is done, the next thing we're going to do is go to the advanced settings of the program, go to the optimizer settings, select everything, but now we're going to have the viewpoint corrected. Now, this is only a feature which you find in PTGui Pro, by the way, so don't search if you don't have the Pro version. When you look at the source images, you will see that the first 6 images were shot from the same point, rotating with the panoramic head. Now, the last one, this one here, was the one when I held the tripod sideways just to get a shot of the spot where the tripod itself used to be in the first series of images. So, as this image is probably taken from a slightly different position, we'll need to have a viewpoint optimization checked in. Now, the viewpoint optimization will only work when we have control points which are in the same plane of another picture. So we can't allow the control point finding algorithm to find control points which are not on the ground of this image. So to prevent this from happening, we're going to open the image in the masking tab and we're going to mask everything out that we don't want the control point finder to find control points in. So we'll leave the ground there. If I hit the Alt key, I can actually remove something from that. Now, this is all not on the ground itself, so I'm going to mask all this stuff out. There we go. And then there's a tiny bit here. Okay. And that's it. Now, another thing I will do right here is just mask out the tripod itself. When you hold the Shift key, you can draw lines in the masking editor, which is very handy. So let me just edit this out. There we go. That's just done. I will now go align the images and let the control point finder do its job. So again, it will analyze the images, find the overlapping areas by finding control points and then aligning them to figure out which way the images have to be arranged so that they overlap. Now let's have a look at that. If we just run the optimizer again, we'll get a good. That's great. Now, looking at the image just as it comes out of the algorithm, that's looking nice. It's already pretty straight. So in that case, I will just skip adding vertical control lines. You can see how to do this in the last tutorial that I showed you. If we look down, this is almost perfect. There's just a wee bit of the flare left from the lens. So switch back to the masking editor and go into the first set of images and just mask out the flare here. If you are lucky to have an 8mm fisheye lens by Sigma, not like the Peleng I have here, then you probably won't have these kinds of issues, but they're very easily taken care of. I just select the bottom here. What I could actually do is just copy and paste the mask from one image to another. There we go, that's a bit faster. So if we just go back to the previewer, we will see that the ground is now flawless. Now, the last thing that I will do here is go into the HDR tab and optimize a wee bit the vignetting of the lens. I will even optimize the exposure just a wee bit and select the camera response curve to be a default curve. We don't need this to be changed. And I'll leave the white balance untouched because I had manual white balance. So we just run the optimizer. There we go. So I think that's us done with this image. I could add some vertical control points just to straighten it up, but apart from that, we're ready to go. So I'm just going to go to the Create Panorama tab. You've seen this in the previous image, in the previous tutorial. I'm just going to select some size here. There we go. I would again select the Smart Blank plugin, the Langchor 16 TIFF, and storing it as LZW. And then at that point, I'm just going to hit Create Panorama. And PTGui is going to start doing its work. I will show you the image once the export is done in a minute. Okay, welcome back. PTGui has just finished exporting the image. Let's open it in PanoVGL to review it. I've told you about this program in the last tutorial. It's very handy to have. There we go. Go full screen. And let's have a look around. That's looking really good. We don't see any discontinuous or broken lines. And now just checking down in the natural direction, the nadir, that's worked also perfectly. You don't see any real difference as to where the tripod was, and that was the objective. So there we go. As you saw, that's very easy to do away with the tripod, especially with the masking feature that was just introduced a short while ago in PTGui version 9. So there you go. Thanks for your attention for this tutorial. I will show you in the last part of this series how to edit the vertical down direction just to do away with the flare issues that we had in the first series of images. All right, thanks for your attention and talk to you soon. Bye.